Hello, my name is Jeff Pearce, and this is Ethiopia. I want to tell you a story. It's about here, but it's really about everywhere, because something happened here that changed the entire world. Once upon a time, in 1935, there was a beautiful country, and then there was a war. Benito Mussolini wanted an empire, and he decided to invade Ethiopia to get it. Maybe you learned about colonial empires in school, but this is the first time that African warriors with spears and antique rifles took on modern troops in tanks. And guess what? The Africans, the Ethiopians, did a pretty good job of holding them back. But that's not even half of the incredible aspects of this story. The world cared for once. Emperor Haile Selassie said no to Mussolini, but much of Europe said no too. America said no. On a hot August day in 1935, 20,000 people marched in Harlem in sympathy for a faraway African nation. Imagine that. This was a time of whites-only drinking fountains and back entrances at hotels. This was long before the Black Panthers and the Pride of Roots. Imagine the thousands. This is the epic you've never heard of, with its own amazing cast of characters. There was the con man villain Hubert Julian, the Black Eagle, and the quiet hero John Robinson, known as the Brown Condor. Celebrities weighed in on the controversy. Josephine Baker, George Bernard Shaw, Trotsky, Churchill, Gandhi, they all had opinions. Langston Hughes wrote poems about it. Marcus Garvey was fuming away writing editorials. Nelson Mandela, 17 years old, was watching and learning to hate fascism. British battleships sailed into the Mediterranean for a white-knuckle showdown with Italy. We could have had the Second World War years earlier. A Broadway play was censored over it. Later, there were gas bombs thrown in a movie theater all the way in Shanghai, just because it showed a documentary on, yes, Ethiopia. This conflict had everything. There were spies in London and Rome, and riots in Brooklyn and Chicago, and still more protests. Two reporters got married while there was looting going on in Addis Ababa. And the war had its own share of atrocities and massacres.
So my own estimate is that about 18,000 to 19,000 people died, which is a little less than 20% of the Ethiopian population of Addis Ababa at that time.
No war crime trials were ever held, despite the fact that there were concentration camps and scores of people were slaughtered across the country. Mussolini was determined to put his jackboot down on an innocent people and stamp his face on a nation abandoned by their allies. And yet, this is not just another tale of tears about Africa. This is a story about a courageous people who fought back. They had their own heroes in the struggle, both men and women, including this young man, a boy turned general, Jigama Kello. This is a story in which the Africans win in the end. I've written a book about all of this. It's called Prevail. This is the history that you never learned about in school, about a war that changed the world. It inspired the first independence movements in Africa. It's why we had propaganda and psychological warfare in Iraq and Afghanistan. It helps explain why the Middle East is the way it is today. It all comes down to this special place and time. It's an inspiring real-life epic, and I want to share it with you.